But I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. It is the hours upon us. It is 10:30 a.m. God is still in the blessing business, and we're here to lift him up in praise. But David said, let everything that hath breath praise God. Amen.
Another chance.
Yes.
Thank you for looking beyond all our imperfections,
yes,
all our mistakes.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for loving us in spite of us.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We're here.
Yes.
because you bless us. Yes. To get up, you bless us to dress ourselves.
Yes.
You clothe us in our right mind.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For eyes to see and ears to hear, and yes, hallelujah, and legs to walk. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God, I thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, for food on our tables.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, for shoes on our feet. Thank you for shelter and transportation.
Thank you.
Can nobody do it like you can? Can nobody love us like you can? You hadn't retired from being God. You hadn't put in your resignation for blessing us. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You yet remain the fundamental doctrine of true religion. Thank you, Lord. You're the greatest phenomenon that has ever crossed the horizon of this world. You are God.
Yes.
You are wellspring of wisdom.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You are our gateway to glory.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You're the Prince of Peace.
Yes.
You rule and you reign.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. That you're yet in control of this world.
Yes.
You're the master of this universe.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And we want you to know this morning, we want you.
Yes,
Lord, we want you.
Yes, Lord.
We want you to have your way.
Yes.
We want you to be God,
yes,
in the midst,
yes,
of us.
Yes.
We want you, Lord, to move on the altar of our hearts.
Yes.
We want you, Lord, to heal those that are sick.
Yes.
We want you, God, to deliver those that are bound with addictive habits that,
yes,
can't,
some, yes,
that can't shake on their own.
Yes.
We want your power, God, to have its way. Moving our world and the White House and,
yes,
area auxiliary, area authority.
Yes, yes.
We pray, God, that they will begin to reverence you as God.
Yes.
We ask you, Lord, to remember the sick in their affliction and those,
yes,
in the hospital bed,
yes,
this morning that's paralyzed. I pray for my cousin, God, that's going through cancer treatments, radiation,
yes,
and having to fly her to different hospitals. But God, her life is in your hands. And we lift her up before you in the mighty name of Jesus. There's some things in the world we don't understand. But God, we know it's not for us to understand everything. But it's for us to trust you. You know what's best. You know the plans that you have for us. And God, we ask you, Lord, to give us the grace to put all our trust and confidence in you. We ask you to continue to bless the pastor of this church. Every member, every auxiliary, continue to lift your people, God, that we may be the people on earth that you ordained for us to be, and that we may walk, God, in the way you want us to walk. And let the words, God, that we hear with our ears this morning, let them be engrafted in our hearts, that they may bring forth the fruit that the word pretends. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, and we give you glory. In Jesus' name. And amen.
Amen. Our scripture reading will come from the 100th number of the Psalms. Which will also be part of our preaching text this morning. The 100th number of the Psalms. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endured throughout all generations. Amen.
Amen.
say amen. Amen. It is good to be here in the house of worship again. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Amen. As we prepare for our tithes and our offering, you can't leave God's giving, no matter how you try. For the more you give, the more he gives to you. Amen. If we have two youth that would volunteer to help us this morning, we would be grateful. Let me see. Okay, go ahead. There's one. Amen. And then need one more. Let me see. Oh, yeah, Kennedy. There's Kennedy. Amen. Go ahead, Kennedy. Yeah. Amen.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
I would like to remind everybody of Mother's Day. If anyone would have any Mother's Day dedication, please get those to me as soon as you can so we can have them all set and ready for Mother's Day. There will be a joint Southwest District meeting on Saturday, May 4th from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. at Lane Chapel C.M.E. Church in Huntsville, Denmark, Tennessee. Your shepherd in Christ, Elder Claude A. Bass, presiding elder of Southwest District. The host will be, the zone will be Lane Chapel, Huntsville, Denmark, host Denmark, Jones Chapel, Mother Lippley, and Blairs Chapel. On today, the pastor and the choir will be going to Lane Tabernacle on Hale Street at 2:30 p.m. They will be serving lunch, and if you'd like to serve lunch, they will be having starting lunch at 1 o'clock a.m.
P.M.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Today is our annual Minister Spouse Day. The minister spouses, widows, the Department of Christian Methodist Episcopal Church will be celebrating the minister spouse today. We would like to thank everybody that's here today, but we also like to all stand today and give our First Lady, Sister Angela Cole, a hand clap. We would like to honor her today. And with just a small token from Blair's Chapel family.
Amen.
Are there any guests in the house today? If there are any guests, from Pastor Cole, Sister Angela Cole, and the entire Blair's Chapel family, we'd like to thank you for coming, and please come again. Thank you.
Amen. The meeting at Lane Chapel in Huntersville will actually be a full quarterly conference that that will take place at 10 a.m. on Saturday from 10 to 12. So I just want to let you all know that kind of short notice, but I had to give it to you when I got it. Amen. 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 So it will be this coming Saturday at 10 and should be done by noon. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So good to see all of you here today. I ask that you keep my family in your prayers. My sister on Thursday in Detroit, 78, passed away. And so we are still making arrangements. But just keep us in your prayers. Amen.
Amen.
She had a life well lived. And so there's no need for us to, as I said to my youngest sister, there's no need for us to be showing out and cutting up because she had a great life. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And so we are thankful for the time that God loaned her to us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So when the arrangements are made, I'll notify the rest of you, everybody else. Amen. Her husband is in charge. So, and he basically said he didn't want nobody else involved, and that's her husband. That's his prerogative. Amen.
Right.
Amen. So that's what I had to tell some of my folks sometimes. We meddle sometimes, and we ought to just shut up. Amen. So I'm grateful that the life that she lived, and so precious memories.
Amen.
Will be with me forever. I think they want us to, thanks Sister Vita said one. So anytime between 1 and 1:30 is when Lane Tabernacle wishes for us to arrive at their service today. They want to serve a meal, and then we will go. They say we will immediately go into afternoon service. This is beginning their revival, their spring revival. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. May God bless you. Here's my prayer. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this day. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for being with us.
Yes, Lord.
Even during difficult times.
Yes.
God, you're right there by our side.
Yes.
So, Lord, we thank you for health. We thank you for strength. Mm-hmm. We thank you for ability.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for everything.
Thank you, Lord.
God, you didn't have to wake us up today, but you did. And I'm reminded of the scripture that says, morning by morning, new mercies that we see. And so we're grateful today because of new mercies. Even though we woke up and we looked the same, but we're still in new mercies. Even though sometimes we feel the same, but we're still in new mercies. God, we're thankful because every day is a brand new day. One that we've never seen before, nor will ever see again. And then, Lord, we just ask today that you continue to be with us as we travel along this life highway. Sometimes it gets tough. The road gets tough and friends are few, but we know that thou art with us. And then, Lord, those who are sick, Lord, we ask that you continue to bless them and strengthen them. Lord, the name comes to mind of Mr. Brad Moore, who was sick almost unto death. But God, you are healing, and you have kept him alive and brought him back, and he's on the road to recovery. So, Lord, we just ask that you continue to strengthen him and his wife and his entire family as you see fit. And then, Lord, those in our midst, those who are in this church, those who are sick, Lord, we ask that you continue to go with them and stand by them. Bless them, bless their families, the ones who are taking care of them, Lord. Continue to strengthen them day by day. Because we know, Lord, it gets hard sometimes. But we are reminded. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. And then, Lord, I ask that you bless every church door that's open in your name today. All of the pastors and preachers who are standing to break the bread of life, Lord, ask that you just anoint them, crown their head with, anoint their head with oil from the top all the way to the bottom of their feet, and help them that they may break bread and share a relevant word to these your people today. Lord, I ask that you touch and bless my family, those who are in Detroit, Michigan, and beyond, Lord. During the loss of my sister, but Lord, we know that this is not the end. This is only the beginning. And so, Lord, we're grateful today that you just let us be with her for a little while. For just shy of 78 years, Lord, you are good. And so, those who've lost loved ones, strengthen them. Those who have loved ones that are in the process of transitioning, strengthen them, Lord. And then help families that they may come together and share good memories of their loved ones without fussing and arguing and bickering, Lord. Help them to find a spirit of love that they may share good news, all of the good things and not the bad. And then those who are out here struggling with addiction, Lord, we ask that you continue to strengthen them, Lord, because they're struggling, Lord, and they're trying and they keep trying. And every time it takes two steps forward, they go two steps forward, steps backwards. But Lord, we know that you are a God who is able. Lord, help them, those who are struggling with drug and alcohol addiction. Lord, strengthen them right now. And then Lord, as we come into the church on Sunday morning and we lift our voices in worship and praise, help us that when we leave these doors, that we will go out and share with a dying world that Jesus died, but he rose again. And that he's coming back one day.
Yes.
Tell somebody, Lord, we want you to just give us the strength and give us the heart and the might to tell somebody, just like he saved us, he can save them. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for a Bible with 66 books where we can read and we can share and we can pray to you and ask for insight and understanding, and you will give it to us. That we may help someone lost in the valley trying to get home. And then, Lord, not only are we praying for our friends, we pray for our enemies, those who plot and plan and seek to do us harm. Lord, we ask that we pray for them, that you will prick their hearts and help them to come into complete submission to you. and to your will. And then, Lord, we ask that you search us today. And if there be anything in us that shouldn't be, Lord, we ask that you remove it right now. So that we may be a light in a dark world. That somebody will look to us and say, truly, they must be a child of God. So, Lord, be with us in this service today. And we'll forever be mindful to give you the glory. Because you are worthy of all the glory. We'll give you the praise. For you are worthy of all the praise. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
He can work it out. And can you just tell the Lord, Lord, I know you're going to work it out. Can y'all tell the Lord that? Lord, I know you're going to work it out. Is that all right? But Cena going to lead it. But we're going to need y'all to help us. Is that all right? Amen. Come on now. Don't play with it. All right.
just does my heart well to hear her sing like all the songs she sang.
Mama, I know you're tired. Just do a little bit. This for your family, okay? Sing it for your family. Can you sing this one for your family?
Yeah, that's what I need, prayer.
opportunity to come before you and share your word, Lord. I ask that you just give me preaching power or something that I may say to these your people that will help someone who is struggling today, someone who is trying to have a better relationship with you. Now, in the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray, and all be to your glory. Amen.
Amen.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It is good to be in the presence of you all today and in the constant presence of God. We count it all joy for everything that the Lord has done for us. All honor and glory to God, Jesus Christ, our Lord, the Holy Spirit, our comforter and our guide, to Reverend Ida Merriweather, who is looking so beautiful in her blue hat today. Amen. To Reverend Womack, Reverend Nelson, Elder Harper, Minister Perry, who is with us today. And to the First Lady of this church, Ms. Angela Cole, to God be the glory. For a few minutes today, from the passage that I read earlier, from the 100 number of the Psalms. Verse 2 says, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. So I just want to lift as a thought today, or subject, if you will. I want to talk about a lifetime of happiness. Amen. A lifetime of happiness. Ushers, thank you. You may be seated. And I see two young ushers back there. Well, it's actually three. Amen. They just been rotating and everything this morning. Amen. Amen. Train them up in the way they should go. Amen. If we took a poll and ask people, what is it that you want most out of life? If you were in the shopping center or Walmart or at the gas station, or and someone walked up to you and asked, what is it that you want most out of life? Most people would say, I just want to be happy. Most people would say that. I just want to be happy. But the question is, what does it mean to just be happy?
All right.
What does it mean? And if you ask most people, they would say, well, if I had the right kind of house and the right job and a few more zeros onto the money in my bank account, that would make me happy. But regardless of the answers that we get, we are soon confronted with the fact that none of those things will truly make you happy. Happiness in material things is flimsy and circumstantial. In other words, you're happy as long as you got it. But as soon as you lose it, or you can keep it, and as soon as you get used to it, as the old folks used to say, you start looking for something else to make you happy. But true happiness, a lifetime happiness, is contagious. I remember the song by Pharrell Williams, who had a hit song called Happy. And people were humming it, even the folks that even didn't even know the words to it. And he said, I'm happy because I clap along like I'm in a room that don't have a roof. I'm happy, I clap. And if you feel like happiness is the truth, because I'm happy, clap along if you know what happiness is to you. But where does Pharrell's happiness come from? It comes from the fact that at the time of him writing this song, he was in love. He is convinced that his love relationship is the key to his happiness. And nothing can take that happiness away. This text in the 100 number of Psalms is talking about the joy of entering the presence of God. Because when we enter the presence of God, we should be happy. We ought to serve the Lord with gladness, come before his presence with singing. We ought to sing songs of joy and happiness, and we should be happy to lift our voices with gladness, singing and thanksgiving. I was listening to the song the other day that came on by Pharrell Williams, and I saw a vision of the church of Jesus, a church that is high on love for Jesus Christ, a celebratory sanctuary filled with worshiping people who is high on love, and can't nothing bring them down. The love of Jesus for us ought to spark some happiness in here this morning. Because Jesus loves us, we ought to clap our hands like we in a room that don't have no room. Because Jesus loves us, it should make us feel that that's what we have to do. Because he loves us, happiness is the truth. Our love relationship with Jesus is all the reason we need to raise the roof in worship with gladness in our heart. It's all the reason we need to come before his presence with singing and thanksgiving. This church should be just like that church in Acts when they were breaking bread together with gladness and singleness of heart. And when we look at the relationship that we have with Jesus, the first thing we ought to recognize is, church, that God loves us. Romans 5 and 8 says, but God commended his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Did it make you happy? Let me hit stop and rewind and press play. It says, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners. He didn't demand that we clean up our act first. Before he went to the cross, he looked at us through our wretched situation. We were liars and thieves and murderers, gossipers, adulterers, fornicators, and he saw our self-righteousness, our lack of commitment, our blindness, our greed, our lust, our jealousy, and our hatred toward one another, but yet he died. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. God didn't come for us because we deserve it. Nobody sitting in this sanctuary this morning is saved because you've been so good. He just loves us. He didn't come because we're so righteous. He just loves us. He didn't come for us because he felt that we would be good someday. He came because he loves us. God just loves us. Even when we mess up and we trip and we fall, he still loves us. Even when we mess up, he still loves us. When we say we're not going to do it anymore, but we do it anyway, he still loves us. When we make a vow to never go back in that direction, but we go back in that direction, he still loves us. When we're down to our last dime, when the doctor say, I can't do nothing else. When we're divorced, when we have a baby out of wedlock, when our backs are against the wall, when we wind up in prison at the bottom of the barrel, God still loves us. When we're suffering from drug and alcohol addiction, when we're homosexual or abused or sexually abused, wherever you find yourself this morning, you can rejoice in the fact that God hates the sin, but he loves the sinner. Amen. Paul says, for scarcely, for a righteous man, will one die. Yes. Yet perhaps, for a good man, somebody would even dare to die. But God commended his love toward us that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died. To open the door to salvation that we may become righteous saints, Christ died for everybody. Isn't that wonderful news? He died for me and he died for you. And maybe that's what makes it so hard for sinners to receive him. Christ's love is a too good to be true kind of love. And it's just waiting there for you to claim it. Let me say this. Everybody at some point in time has ownership in something that you have not claimed. Let me say that again. All of us have ownership in something at some point in our lives that we have not claimed. Make it make sense, Pastor. Let me see, can I do it? Everybody at one point in time was unsaved. That's why Big Mama and them make you sit on the mourner's bench. Because they knew you cut up all the time. And they know you were stealing cookies out the cooking jar. And taking money from other folks and beating up on people and bullying folks. So they brought you in and set you on the mourner's bench. Because they wanted you to claim something that belonged to you that you didn't know belonged to you. And that's salvation. I hope I'm making sense to somebody in here. And then we should consider the power of the love of Christ. Romans 8:35 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Jesus is our conqueror. He can divide the Red Sea. And if he can do that, he can make a way out of no way for you. If he can restore a dead man back to life, he can restore your relationship. If he can know a man's thoughts from afar off, he can read your mind and your heart. And then when it comes to his desires for your life. Now this is good. Y'all got to hear this. You got to hear this. Nobody has to approve his plan before he executes it. Look here, that shouting stuff right there. When you get ready to get saved, and you give your life to Christ, don't nobody have to approve it. Jesus don't have to ask for nobody's approval to save you. Okay. When you sin and you go to God. And you say, Lord, forgive me. He don't call no church conference. Somebody better help me preach in here. When you try to give your life to Christ, he don't have to. Well, let me break it down. He ain't gotta ask nobody. He just forgives. Look here. And then, he ain't got running by nobody. In other words, he can bless you. He can bless you, Miss Fanny, and he ain't got to ask nobody. Your enemies can be plotting your downfall, Miss R.C., but he'll make your enemy your footstool. Because there is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, you ain't got to be jealous and hating on them, because what he's done for others, he can do the same thing for you. Jesus said, and I'm done. Jesus said in Matthew 28 and 18, all power is given unto him in heaven and in earth. And guess what? He meant what he said. Jesus can make a corrupt man a good man. He can make a drunk man a sober man. He can make a greedy man a generous man. He can make a weak man a strong man. But I ain't just talking about the men. He can make a carnal woman a holy woman. He can make a lying woman an honest woman. He can make a troubled woman a peaceful woman. He can make a rude woman a kind woman. But I'm not just talking about the women. He can make a shameful child a modest child. He can make a restless child a calm child. He can make a worldly child a spiritual child. He can make a miserable child a happy child. There is no resentment, no guilt, no misery or shame that the power of God cannot erase. That's why we got a lifetime of happiness. Because Jesus pledged his love. And because he pledged his love, nobody can stop it. And then it says in 1 John 3 and 23, and this is his first commandment, that we should believe on the name of his son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he gave us commandment. Loving one another is not an option. It is a solemn obligation. Rewind, press play. Loving one another is not an option. It's a solemn obligation. Rewind, press play. Loving one another is not an option. It's a solemn obligation. In other words, we ain't got no choice in the matter. He said, do it, and that's what we're supposed to do. He says, because he loves us, we ought to love one another. And our gladness in this spiritual house is built on our acceptance of that sacred resolution. Jesus loves us, and since he loves us, we ought to love one another. And we ought to celebrate with singleness of heart because we are one in Christ. The body of Christ has many members, not all the same office. Let me say, don't you think it goes for all of us. Don't you think you're going to stop nothing. Because the body of Christ got many members. And if you get mad and sit down, he'll raise somebody else up. Somebody go help me preach in a minute. The body of Christ has many members. But not all of us got the same office. Look, if I get mad and say I ain't going to preach no more, guess what? God going to help somebody else. Huh? You get mad and say I ain't singing no more, guess what? God will bring somebody else up. He'll bring somebody else up here you didn't even know could sing. And they'll sing so lovely that everybody in here will be crying and hollering. Okay. See, when we enter the house of God, we ought to be happy. In the book of Acts, Luke wrote of the early church. And they continuing daily with one accord, breaking bread from house to house, they eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. Is y'all hear me? Said having favor with all. You know, everybody in here, I know everybody in here educated, know how to spell. Capital A, capital L, capital L. All the people. And then this is what happened. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. So wait. Back up. If we are on one accord, break bread from house to house, eat our meat with gladness and singleness of heart, stop complaining about every little old thing. Praising God, having favor with all the people, even the ones you claim you don't like, you ought to have some favor with them. Then the Lord added to the church daily, it should be saved. Who wouldn't want to join a church like that? Everybody that's happened to know the truth of Christ's love. Everybody praising God. Everybody getting along. That kind of gladness will make anybody happy. So, we serve the Lord with what? Gladness. Come before his presence with singing. That's our way of telling God, thank you for all that you've done and all that you're doing and all that you're going to do. Because, you know, I think about that passage, morning by morning, new mercies I see. New mercy. Every day. New mercy.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Now, we don't think about that as often as we should.
That's right, Pastor.
Because when we get up in the morning, we look in the mirror, we just see the same old person. But God is giving us new mercy.
That's right.
Think about it.
New mercy.
What if every day you woke up, you looked in your driveway, and there was a new car? You drove it one day, and the next day you got a new one. Next day you got, that's what new mercy is. New mercy is a new car smell. Every day because of his new mercies, you got a new car smell. Because of God's mercy. And it's new and fresh every morning. That leads to a lifetime of happiness. Look, when I get up in the morning, early in the morning. And once I get over myself, that's the first thing we got to do. We get up, you know, you can't move like you used to. You know, you can't jump up. Yeah, you can't just jump up out the bed. That old knee bothering and back hurting and neck hurting. And your head throbbing and all that. And once you get over yourself, think about the new mercies that God has given. Look, you got up. You got up with arthritis, rheumatism, diabetes, heart trouble, all kind of stuff. But you got some new mercy because it's a brand new day. So, I don't know about you. I don't know about you. When I get up early in the morning, and once I get over all that stuff, oh man, good God, man, I don't know. I don't even walk right when I get up. I'm hopping. I'm like an old car. I gotta warm up.
Amen.
Yeah, I mean, y'all don't know nothing about that. But I gotta warm up when I get up. When I walk through the house. And sometimes I see First Lady just kind of look at me. Because she see that hitch in my giddy up. I ain't walking like I've been walking. But then I walk back through there, and she look at me again, and I'm stepping like I'm 16. Because of new mercy. See, I didn't complain. I didn't go in there, hey, baby, oh my goodness, oh my. You know, we do that. We like to complain. I didn't complain. I just said nothing. I just walked through there. She doing what she do. I'm just, you walk through. You just want them to see you. Just want them to see you. Know you're still here. And then I walk back. And then I think.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, you've been mighty good to me.
Yes, Lord.
And then all of a sudden, I just straighten up. And I walk back through the house. Because I want her to look at me again. See how good I'm looking. I look like I was broke down at first. She don't want to look at no broke down man. So I said, let me walk back through there so she can see me one more time. How God done blessed me to have some new mercy. If that ain't your story, keep on living. Wait a minute, everybody in here, who in here married? You know what I'm talking about, don't you? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. And the ones that ain't married, if you shacking, you know that too, don't you? I ain't mad, and I'm just throwing that out there. This ain't no sermon about shacking, okay? It's about happiness. It's about a lifetime of happiness. Regardless of what your situation is, God is giving you new mercy. Each and every day, be thankful. Be grateful. Be happy. Don't worry about what you don't have. Worry about what you got left. You may not be able to walk like you used to walk. You may not be able to talk like you used to talk. You may not be able to hear like you used to hear. You may not be able to see like you used to see. But you can still see. And you can still eat. You can still eat. Because, and then I'm done, and we're going to open the doors. Because even when you eat, you know, when you get older sometimes and you lose a tooth or two, God doesn't. Created a way for us to get some new ones, didn't he? Y'all might as well say amen. Amen. Happiness. Lifetime happiness. God will bless you. And he's blessing you now. Every day. Every day. If you just think back of the rough times that you had and God done brought you out. Because of new mercy.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy God.
Be happy with what God is doing. Be happy. God is still in the blessing business. He may not come when you want him, but he's always on time. Let us stand. Doors of the church, or doors to Christian discipleship are open. For someone who may wish to give their life to Christ today, do it while there's still time. God hates sin, but he loves the sinner. Because if he didn't love the sinner, then none of us would be here today. He loves us in spite of what we do. You can give your life to Christ today. And you can say, Lord, I need you. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's good to know. And some of us in here today can testify that we called on the name of the Lord one day and God saved us. If there be one today who wants to give their life to Christ, someone who may wish to be united with this church, someone who may wish to be a candidate for baptism, you can come at this time. And you too can be saved and have a lifetime of happiness. If there be none, you may be seated.
Amen.
brother sitting back there with the white suit on. What's your name, sir?
Ragnar. M.C. Ragnar.
Okay.
Sister, yeah.
Oh! Okay. All right. You have a great sister.
Amen.
Yeah, great. Have a singing sister, too. Amen. 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 Thank you, and good to see you, sir. Amen. Let us pray. No, it was Friday. This is real quick. Real quick. She went to the prom. As the daddy, I didn't really want her to go to the prom. With no date and all that kind of stuff. You know, they get older, they start coating and all that. Y'all know what that means. Okay. I'm about to tell you, brown little. But you know what? She is right. But we are extremely proud of her. And we went to the prom Friday night, her and a date. And we took pictures. And then the first lady went up to the car while they trying to back out the driveway. She taking pictures of them in the car. You know, I said, what she think going to happen? A missing person report? She going to need it for that or something? But to all of these young people who are seniors in high school, in college, about to leave middle school, congratulations to you. And God bless you. And I think all the fathers that are sitting in here know what I'm talking about when it comes down to those daughters. Amen. We don't want to let them go, but sooner or later we have to. So we just pray God bless and thankful that she has a nice, that she went with a nice young man. Amen. I don't think he know I like him even to this day. Because I don't let him know that. Amen. Amen. But just grateful. Just grateful. Amen. Let us pray. Now unto him who's able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Yes. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, yes, both now and forever. Let us all say together. Amen.